Global equities stumbled and crude oil prices declined by over 13% from recent peaks, with fears of a taper tantrum unsettling the investor community. Now, taper tantrum is a phrase used in the economic parlance to mean a tightening in the quantitative easing by central banks. It made headlines after the US Fed's July policy meeting showed that the central bank might gradually pull back its bond buying program by late 2021. Market watchers, however, believe that a rapid spread of the Delta variant of coronavirus, along with slackening economic growth in China, makes a case for the status quo on policy stance. Business Standard spoke to Devang Mehta, head of equity advisory at Centrum Wealth, and Sunil Subramaniam, MD and CEO at Sundaram Mutual Funds, to understand the global market scenario and how investors should position themselves in this volatile market. What's happening in the global markets?
The taper tantrum seems to be back right now. The US Fed has indicated that at some point this year, they will sort of taper its purchases of bonds. In simple terms, what this means is that whatever easy liquidity that was being provided to the developed and the emerging markets, this money was finding its way to equities, to commodities, to other risky asset classes. And equity investors as well as commodity investors across the world want that this easy money policy or this easy liquidity continues for a while. Whether this is possible, I think the answer is no. This can't last till eternity. And the reaction for this, we have seen in the last couple of days how crude has probably come down to $65 or $66 per barrel. Metals have corrected. The dollar has strengthened to around, say, 93, 93.5. So yes, this there is always a bit of overreaction. And in a market where probably in every market we have doubled from the bottoms, there has to be some bit of correction. There has to be some bit of sanctity which should come to the proceedings, which will in fact be good for the health of the market. So I think some ebbs and corrections are always desired in a raging bull market.
How will the taper tantrum affect Indian markets?
Now, what does this have an impact on? What impact this has on Indian markets and what should be our prospects? Yes, Indian market also can correct in line with what is happening across the developed and the other emerging markets. Yes, we have also rallied and sort of aped the markets. Liquidity, which is one of the important parameter, can be questioned or can be challenged for some time. But rather, Indian investors, Indian mutual funds, insurance companies, retail investors, all this have been a strong force to reckon with. A lot of investors have been sort of left out of this bus or boat for some time. I think a lot of these people on a smaller correction of say 3%, 5%, 7% would want to come into the markets and buy quality stocks. So my sense is that overall the Indian markets, if at all we find a good correction, one should start investing. Yes, start investing via SIP, start investing via tranches. A lot of good businesses will be available at some decent valuations. The earnings are going to be extremely, extremely good for the next 2 to 3 years. So I think the fund flows in the Indian market shouldn't be a problem. Yes, FII flows can suffer for some time if at all this taper thing goes on. But in this backdrop, I think the road ahead for the Indian equity markets will probably have smaller setbacks in a bull market. But this should be used as an opportunity in adversity rather than counting it as only as adversity.
Is the recent sell-off on Dalal Street justified?
The Indian markets had reacted to the tapering news with a sell-off. And this was combined with the news of the Delta variant gaining traction, right? But in our view, this is a little bit overdone. The reasons for the same being that tapering will go forward strongly only if growth concerns remain, means the growth comes back on track. So the Delta variant coming means the tapering actually got postponed.
Does taper tantrum present any long-term opportunity for Indian markets?
So over the longer period of time, while tapering could cause impact on the markets, the fact of the matter is there are 2-3 things which are countering this force. The first is that Indian exports will get a boost from recovering global growth, which is partly the cause of tapering. That's number one point. The second point is that Indian markets today are not in such a high level of FPI domination because retail investor base has grown widely as seen from the demat account growth and mutual fund inflows. Hence, there should be enough buying capacity in the Indian markets for any sell-off. So we believe that the reactions are overdone and that with a little bit of volatility, the market should settle down, taking into discount the Indian growth story and hence will post fresh rise in the coming years.
Other triggers that could sway markets?
Figures for the Indian stock market in the coming weeks and months are essentially the progress on the vaccination front and how far the third wave comes into being and impacts the economy. That's one trigger to observe. The second trigger to observe is the Diwali festival season is on us. And how does the second wave impacted the consumption? How does the bounce back, the pent-up demand come in and show those numbers? That's the second trigger. The third trigger would be inflation, because imported inflation due to oil and commodities could spike up inflation, but that's not the real concern. RBI will be more concerned about demand-led inflation. And so that will determine RBI outlook, which, as you know, has a very strong correlation with the markets. So domestically, these are the three triggers. Internationally, Fed tapering, as well as global growth recovery and Delta variant are the triggers to watch for.
Road ahead for Indian equity and investment strategy.
From that perspective, the outlook for the Indian economy is that once we are past these recent set of triggers, we should be on a strong growth path, because the export-driven, PLI-driven export drive and the infrastructure that will follow through from that will give a lot of business for small and medium cap companies in domestic market, and hence a broad-based rally should ensue. Investors should position themselves in this time of volatility by essentially adopting a systematic approach either through SIP or STP and keeping a reasonable, so I would say 30% in large caps, 40% in mid caps and 30% in small caps would give a good allocation. The alternative is to choose a multi-cap or a flexi-cap fund, which would essentially be doing it around these cap curve allocations. That's my recommendation for investors in these volatile times.
Investment worthy stocks and sectors, I can also say some themes and sectors. Financialization is one extremely interesting theme where one should probably look at longer term investments in insurance stocks, be it life insurance, be it general insurance, good private banks, certain NBFCs, consumer facing NBFCs, some intermediaries should also be looked at in this environment. So I think one, financialization theme is doing extremely well. The second theme of formalization, where I always talk about companies in building materials, FMCG, all this will also do extremely well. Companies in the paints universe, adhesives, ceramics, some part of cement, capital goods, automation, IT related and IT allied stories, which will keep on doing well as productivity enhancement is going to be the theme. This sectors will also tend to do well. Healthcare has also emerged very well. Niche pharma companies, niche MNC companies, diagnostic companies, agrochemical, chemical, API related companies, all these companies would also probably form a very good universe to invest. I think one more sector which one should look at also is consumer discretionary, maybe discretionary consumption as well as non-discretionary consumption. FMCG should also be qualified as a wonderful sector to get into. As unlock happens, consumer confidence will come back over a longer period, and I don't see any reason why this stock should underperform. So I think these are some of the sectors which, if investors buy in tranches, I think there is all the way good money to be made over the next 3-5 years. Thank you.
Clearly, while Indian markets look poised to scale fresh highs once near-term concerns are addressed, rich valuations and global growth concerns may cap upsides in the second half of calendar year 2021. According to analysts at Bank of America, the Nifty index may correct by 9% in the near term. They have pegged the index at 15,000. From an investment viewpoint, the brokerage is overweight on industrials and financials and underweight on the discretionary segment.
If you like this video, share it and subscribe to Business Standard. For more news, views and insights, log on to www.business-standard.com. Do also follow us on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Telegram and LinkedIn.